Good morning, students. Today we are going to see about structure of mitochondria. Okay, mitochondria is the second largest organelle of the cell. Mitochondria discovered by Kolliker. In striated muscles, mitochondria contain 60 to 70% of protein, 25 to 30% of lipids, 5 to 7% of RNA, and small amount of DNA present. Okay, first see the mitochondria structure of mitochondria. Outer membrane and inner membrane is present. Enfolding of the inner membrane. Mitochondrial structure. Outer membrane. Two membrane present. First one, outer membrane. Second one, inner membrane. Inner membrane space. The finger like projections, cristae present, DNA present, RNA. Next one, ribosome. Okay, first see the mitochondrial membrane. Outer membrane and inner membrane is present. Outer membrane and inner membrane is separated by intermembrane space. Okay, outer membrane is a freely permeable to small molecules. Okay, what is it mean? Freely permeable to small molecule means it allow the water and salt. Okay, it contains proteins, lipids. Okay, next one, inner membrane, it is semi-permeable membrane. What is the meaning of semi? Semi means half permeable membrane. It contains lot of enzymes and carrier protein is present. Okay, next one part, cristae. What is cristae? Cristae means inner membrane of the mitochondria enfolding to the give rise to finger-like projection is called cristae. Finger-like projection is called cristae. Okay, next part, exosome. Fourth one, exosome. Exosome means tennis racket shaped particles is known as exosome. Look like a tennis racket shape. For example, this shape. This is top. This is F1 particles. Okay, F1 particles also known as exosome. What is the main use of exosome? They involve in ATP synthesis. They involve in ATP synthesis. What is the meaning of ATP? ATP means adenosine triphosphate. That is called ATP. Okay. Next one, mitochondrial matrix. Mitochondrial matrix contains lot of enzymes. Next part, mitochondrial matrix. Matrix is contain enzymes. Enzymes used for Krebs cycle, proteins and lipids present. Protein, lipids. Okay, tRNA and small amount of DNA also present. Okay, what is the function of mitochondria? Mitochondria made it is involved in the cellular respiration. Cellular respiration. They produce large number of ATP molecules, so it is called powerhouses of the cell. ATP give energy to the cell, so it is called ATP factory of the cell. They produce ATP molecules. ATP molecules give energy to the cell. Give energy. So it is called powerhouses of the cell. Powerhouses of the cell. Next one, ATP factory of the cell. ATP factory of the cell. Next, last one, second point, it regulates the metabolic activity of the cell. It regulates metabolic activity of the cell. Okay, this is a mitochondrial structure. Next topic, respiration. What is a respiration? Respiration means exchange of gases between the organism and the environment. That is called respiration. Types of respiration. Respiration means exchange of gases. Two type of respiration. First one, external respiration. Second one, cellular respiration. First, external respiration. Second one, cellular respiration. What is external respiration means? Plant obtain energy from the environment. Plant obtain oxygen from the environment and gives a lot of energy. Okay, plant obtain oxygen from the environment, gives carbon dioxide and water vapor. Carbon dioxide and water vapor. It is known as external respiration. It is a physical process. It is a physical process. Next one, cellular respiration. Cellular respiration occurs within the cell. It is a biochemical process. It is a biochemical process. Food is oxidized. This process, food is oxidized, obtain energy. Food is oxidized, obtain energy. Is known as cellular respiration. Okay, what is external respiration? External respiration means plant obtain oxygen from the environment into CO2 and water vapor. It is called external respiration. It is a physical process. Cellular respiration means it is a biochemical product process. Food is oxidized and obtain energy. It is called cellular respiration. Next one, anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration. Next, anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration. respiration. Okay, next, aerobic respiration is a type of cellular respiration. Type of cellular respiration. What is anaerobic respiration means? Organic food is completely oxidized with the help of oxygen. Okay, organic food is completely oxidized with the help of oxygen. With the help of oxygen. Okay, what is aerobic respiration? Aerobic respiration is a type of cellular respiration. Organic food is completely oxidized with the help of oxygen. Recue water and oxygen. Sapa, permission. Energy. Next, glycolysis. What is glycolysis? Glycolysis is glycolysis means glucose splitting the breakdown of one molecule of glucose into two molecules of pyruvic acid. Breakdown of one molecule of glucose into two molecules of pyruvic acid. This reaction takes place inside the cytoplasm. Next one, pyruvic Krebs cycle. Mitochondrial matrix. This region, okay? At the end of the glycolysis, two molecules of pyruvic acid enter into the mitochondrial membrane. Oxidation of pyruvic acid into water and CO2 produced. Okay, water and CO2. Oxidation of pyruvic acid. Next, anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration. What is the meaning? Anaerobic respiration takes place without oxygen. Oxygen is illama nadak without oxygen. Glucose is converted to ethanol. Okay. Next one, respiratory quotient. Respiratory quotient means the ratio of CO2 liberated. Volume of O2 consumed. This very very question for small question. Okay, what is the respiratory question? The ratio volume of CO2 liberated by volume of CO2 consumed. Okay, first unit finished, students. So today homework, learn and write mitochondrial structure of mitochondria. Thank you.